Flange classes play a crucial role in the world of piping and industrial applications, providing a standardized way to identify and categorize flanges based on their pressure-temperature ratings. However, there's a peculiar tradition that has persisted over the years. People often refer to flange classes using the term pound. In this video, we'll delve into the origins and reasons behind this unique nomenclature. The practice of associating flange classes with the term pound can be traced back to historical developments in the field of engineering. Early on, engineers and industry professionals needed a clear and concise way to communicate the pressure-temperature ratings of flanges. The pounds per square inch, PSI, unit became the standard measurement for pressure, and it was only natural for this unit to find its way into the nomenclature of flange classes. As industries grew and standardized practices became imperative for seamless collaboration, the need for a uniform language to describe flange classes became evident. The pounds per square inch unit provided a universally understood metric, ensuring consistency across engineering disciplines and geographic locations. Previously, benchmark temperatures used were different for different materials. However, currently for A105 flanges, class 150 has a rating pressure of 170 psi at 500 Fahrenheit benchmark temperature, and class 300 has a rating pressure of 270 psi at 850 Fahrenheit benchmark temperature. It is clear that current pressure temperature rating is no longer correspond to the original benchmark idea, as you can see on the table 2.1.1. Using pound to denote flange classes also simplified communication within the industry. Engineers and professionals could quickly convey information about a flange's pressure-temperature rating by referring to its class in pounds. This shorthand facilitated efficient communication during design, manufacturing, installation, and maintenance processes. Over time, the association of flange classes with pound became deeply ingrained in the culture of the industry. It turned into a tradition, with new generations of professionals adopting the terminology as part of their engineering lexicon. This cultural continuity helped maintain a sense of shared identity among industry experts. While the use of pound for flange classes might seem unconventional to outsiders, it has become so entrenched in industry practices that any attempt to change the terminology could face resistance. The familiarity and historical significance of the term make it resistant to replacement, and the industry may find it challenging to shift away from this established convention. In the fascinating world of piping and industrial engineering, the enigma of why people call flange classes pound adds a layer of intrigue to an otherwise technical subject. Rooted in history, standardized for consistency, and embraced as tradition, the association of flange classes with pound serves as a testament to the dynamic evolution of language and practices within the engineering community.